Hello friends. I hope during these torrid and uncertain times, you and your families are doing well and are safe. Today I'm here to share my views with you on foreign exchange position in the country. Particularly the US dollar has risen quite a lot against the Indian rupee, and so have the British pound and the euro. This is due to the uncertainty in the financial world caused because of the coronavirus. We are very much tempted to hedge our export receipts because of the wild fluctuations, particularly the upward movement in these three currencies. However, before you do so, let me caution you that there are some issues and points which you need to consider before you take these decisions and sign future contracts with the banks. If you have noticed, the Indian industry is totally locked down because of Prime Minister Modi's announcements safeguarding the country from coronavirus. As a result, none of our export shipments are being shipped across to countries abroad. This being the case, the contracts which we have already signed with the banks, in case they are not delivered, are already in jeopardy, and the organization is facing losses because of the non-deliverables of the export shipments. Hence, I would like you to be extremely cautious and keep in mind these points before you sign any more contracts. The second point is about borrowings. Absolutely fine and true that foreign exchange loans are available much cheaper. For example, the external commercial borrowings. That being the case, we are tempted as an organization to borrow more ECBs for our long-term needs, as well as packing credit in foreign currency for our short-term needs. However, before doing so, we should consider at least partial or total hedging of the currencies, because there is a strong likelihood that these currencies would run much higher than they are today and thus spoil the party which the organization is planning. Another few points which need to be considered are, while entering into such contracts, you need a very strong IT backup system. These contracts, you could have an automated software by which the CFO and his team within the organization gets timely reminders to honor these contracts. The second thing is, the organization should have extremely strong backup of the legal department. The contracts framed by the bankers need to be vetted out perfectly by the legal department, and the business team as well as the finance team need to be aware of the contracts signed and the conditions imposed by the banks. I hope you will take all these into consideration while framing and signing future contracts. I wish you all the best. Stay safe. Thank you.